Start by saying that the worry that becomes topical because of the cost table. You see, we are talking about cost of doing business, and we are looking about at amounts as high as 76 million to an economy as little as Ghana. Then we have a problem. So it is something that affects everybody, whether you are an importer or a consumer. These costs are passed on eventually to all of us. It affects our competitiveness. So, you say the borrow and rent, they are twin brothers. Once you enter the borrow, you are likely to also do rent. So, it's not only the mortgage, but you also pay rent when you don't clear your goods in time. So, you realize that since we started tracking effectively, we started with the borrow in 2016, we started looking at rent as well. So 2016, the mortgage was 95 million. Fortunately, it has gone down. Fortunately, they said that it has gone down. Not because the amount is low, but we are hoping that with this campaign, the mortgage has come down to the fairest age. Unfortunately, rent has been rising from the 2 years that we have. I'm sure somebody asked a question like this, and said, why is the mortgage rising? Demurrage coming down and rent, we'll respond to that later. So this is why we are here. Demurrage is very, very high. A typical demurrage calculation for the rate as we have in Ghana. First 7 days free, from the 8th to 4th, for the 14th day. In Ghana, the minimum charge is $20 a day, and the maximum is $30 per day. Then, from the 15th day to the 21st, the minimum of $25 a day to the maximum of $45 a day. If you still keep your container, if you still keep your cargo in the container after 21 days, then you are paying as much as $40 a day. Or $55, depending on the shipping company you are using. So this is how this starts. And I've seen the mortgage approved to thousands of dollars. It's in dollars, but it is dollar and it is converted into CD. So you can imagine any time the CD depreciates, you know that you have to pay more in terms of the mortgage. A study conducted by the authority shows that over 85% of containerized cargo go on the world. In other words, most important do clear their cargo within the 7 days free period. And that is alarming. It means that we have a lot of work to do. And there are reasons for this. Factors contributing to the demurrage. There's the shipper side, the system side, shipping line side, operator side, etc. So we want to start with the shipper. But a lot can be done by the shipper. I want to say that. Delays in the receipt of cargo documentation, because we also have a department that deals with shipper services or shipper complaints. We see this one a lot. People, their cargoes have arrived, but they don't have all the documentation, so they have to wait. Some don't know that their vessels have even arrived. Some lack funds, even though they have imported. They are not ready with funds to clear. So they'll be going around looking for money to clear the hotel. Others also declaration of inaccurate information. Our customs man here. If you present documentation with faulty information, I'm sure your declaration will go through that. So it affects the days that you take to clear. So that is a very important point. Non-compliance with regulatory agencies. Now I learned the regulatory agencies are very effective. They try to enforce the laws. Food and Drugs Authority is a typical one, Ghana Standards Authority. So if you are importing a food or drug product, you should know from day one that you need to have all the requirements as well as Food and Drugs Authority. So licensing, testing, all that. All this must be done before the vessel arrives or the cargo arrives. If the cargo arrives, and only to realize that you need this, then there will be a problem. Sometimes people import water, they don't even know that water. It has to be checked. So, oh, I guess for it's just some few boxes in my container. Yeah, but food and drugs, they have to see. What's this food? You want to, you know, standards authority or anything that affects the environment, chemicals, EPA, you need to notify EPA, you need to get a license. So your goods have arrived at the top, but you are now running around looking for it. But there are also cases of delivery delays. That's why I don't know the reason. It's not going to decide that you wait a while to play. It's also going to be a play. But it's not only about the shipper, the service providers also have a role to play. Some of our shipping lines have processes that are not easy, are not configurable, a little bureaucratic. And so such lines also need to back up. But at the same time, we also urge shippers, if you go once and you are not treated well at a shipping line, you have the right to change. To decide that you will know, use a different line. All professional conduct of clearing agents. There are some clearing agents who are not professional at all. And then they will delay you. They have your documents, you call them, they will respond. You are running out of time. You don't want your documents. I want to keep the documents for another agent to start and so you can't find it. You know, that is also there. This can also cause delay. So you need to get a competent clearing or forwarding agent. Handle your appeal. Then, difficulty in locating containers at terminals. Yes, at times when it is supposed to have been DCT, but it ends up with another, maybe it's still at MPS, DJT, etc. So, the service provider's tracking system or their ability to also locate all these containers and where they are supposed to be also has a way of affecting. Then systems issues. We know we are used to the GC net, and lately we have the web process, and these are technical service providers to customers. And therefore, if your systems are down, then your declaration too is down. And you have a number of downtimes, and these downtimes affect the time to clear. And it also has a way of affecting us. So our systems also need to be improved. We just introduced a pass, pre-arrival assessment reporting system. It has also gone through, it's a new thing, definitely you have a few challenges. So this also has its hidden problems in terms of the back and forth, you know, in getting your CPR, etc. They are also there. The appeals process, etc. Now, they are not as efficient as we wish it to be. So, it's also part of the problem. And I mentioned the appeal process. Most shippers, if they test or they don't really want to do, they don't want to even try the appeal. Because they know that you lose before you lose that process. You know? And it's all encouraging. So, as yesterday we had a meeting, we were discussing this particular thing. So, we want to encourage. Customs also to be a little, you know, to be helping us so that the process will be favorable to the shippers. Feel free to come and appeal. So, this is one of the problems. And then the impact of demurrage. This one, did I mention? You all know our shippers' profit and working capital gains. Because anytime you pay demurrage, that's a huge amount of your profits that is gone. And it's affected. You have to find another additional money to, you know, to do the importation. Could affect sales volumes of shippers due to high costs. Yes, I claim my need because of the mortgage. Then I need to top up a little. And the cost on the market means that I may not be able to sell as much. So that is the effect. It affects volume. So if I'm importing again, I want to reduce the volumes that I have to import. It increases cost of leaving the country. So all of us, even though we think it's a shipper's problem, but it increases the cost of anything we go to buy on the market. It affects the cost and all that. It affects Ghana's competitiveness for its exports. I think as the CEO was mentioning, even though Ghanaians are your exporter, but a lot of your inputs for your exports are also imported items. So if we have inefficiencies in that system, then you are sure it's affecting your export as well. So it's not only an import problem, it has a way of affecting even our exports. You are even bringing machinery, etc. And you buy, you know, inputs here that are important. So that's a way of. And then it's a foreign exchange drain on the economy. We pay the money to shipping companies who are not Ghanaian. Most of them are all Ghanaians. I don't know if we own any commercial ships in Ghana. Yeah, there's none. So if you are paying, you are paying to the foreign, and it must be paid to the foreign currency. So that one also is affected. So a few recommendations for the problem that this is very clear what we need to do. We need to start that process again. You know, you imported items, so you know when it's supposed to arrive. So you need to start the process even before the cargo arrives. Presently, we have a pre-arrival assessment reporting system. So you can submit certain viable documentation before vessel arrives. So that is what we want. Then our documentation must be genuine. Must be genuine. What does it genuine? I'm sure we know what should be genuine. Yeah, I know I'm a Ghanaian too, so I know what happens. Yeah, so it's not as easy as that, but we have to try. Much as we are asking you to try, we are also telling customs to create a system that is as fair as possible to everybody. So that we encourage everybody to be compliant. Because if I submit my genuine documents, genuine, and then my neighbor is allowed to go with non-genuine documents, then we have a problem. And no business owners will have a thing like that because it will become more competitive on the market. So we are looking at both sides. So submit genuine documents. Get ready in funds. Don't wait till the goods arrive before they are going to look for money. You know, the funds must be ready before the goods arrive. And then you secure all your licenses. You know, you should know once you want to enter into a certain import business, you should know what the requirements are for that particular product. Sometimes it looks very easy. You think that import anything. No. The only problem is that you need to go to the Ministry of Interior for explosives. You need a certain permit. You need TPE. You need the veterinary service. You need all these agencies out there. So we need to do that. Then we also want to encourage full automation of the veterinary process. We can't work for the paper-less project that has started. It's a bold initiative. We need to make it work so that we can remove the human interventions as much as possible. And then you need to also reduce the downtime. You know, they're not the only people. The system is being used everywhere. Why is it always ours? We have downtime. We should check that. If we need broadband, whatever, we need to do that. And then we have always advocated a risk, a robust risk management system. We don't believe that every container that arrives in Ghana must be open. It's not sustainable. We are doing as we need about 3 months in April. I mean, 2 weeks. Import about my figures are about 15 million and it will keep increasing. And I don't know how many customs officers can deploy to open every container if we start going to 15 million. So we must adopt systems that are more efficient than what we do now, trying to open every container. It's not possible. So the way out is a robust risk management system. Food and grants, bring your risk. What are the items that pose the most risk? Let's just have it. Standards, let's have it. You put all in a basket and it generates something. Then that should give us a way of identifying products. So we are just opening about 10% of containers. And we are sure that if we open 10%, we are getting where the corporates are. That is what I mean by robust risk management system. It happens everywhere. When we all travel, we just say pass. We don't move into your days. Yeah, but there's a risk management system. When you are caught, I'm sure you regret that you ever did. So these are the things that we need to do. So customers must not think, because we started the balance, and I saw the figures from the beginning. Then customers was allowed that the green was too much. You know? But we need to put the systems in. We need more greens. Greens must be about 80%. And the red is about 10. That is what we are asking. And then we need to pick up the more customers and promises. We need to do the physical examination. We need to introduce system for location. Yes, the port authorities, the terminal operators, much as we are working, we should invest in systems, IT systems, so that we will be able to locate our containers easily. And then training for our clearing agents. We know that it's difficult. We can't get all of them in offices, etc. But we can give them so minimal training. And I want to appeal to you. We have three associations, a very effective association. We encourage them to train their members as much as possible. So, just to highlight what I've said so far. Demurrage is avoidable. It impacts negatively on the shipper and the economy as a whole. Shipper education is required to reduce the stress of demurrage. And that is what we have started. We'll continue the education that we know that we can let that go without paying one CD demurrage. And then we also want to encourage free arrival for the process, which we believe is the key. I thank you for your attention.
For comprehensive statistics on Ghana's maritime industry, visit our website at www.shippers.org.gh, point to publications, and click on Maritime Trade Statistics.